Welcome to a D20PRO video tutorial. My name is Curtis, and I'll be going over the GM Primary Interface Overview. Getting started with the D20PRO's GM Primary Interface, we see 8 circular buttons on the top left. Starting from the left to right, we have the D20PRO Main Menu, followed by the Rebroadcast Game State button, the Fog of War Mode Toggle button, the Manage Tiles Mode Toggle button, the Combat in Free Mode Toggle button, the Show and Hide GM Roles Toggle button, the Ruler Toggle button, and the Show and Hide Grid Toggle button. Additionally, we have some important information shown on the title bar, including the connection type, whether it's a GM or player connection, your connected screen name, the GM's IP address, and the GM's port number. Moving to the GM's D20PRO Main Menu includes Active Effects. This displays all active effects currently affecting creatures on the map. Core Dice. This is useful for when you want to roll dice. Decision. This displays all submitted effects currently awaiting GM decision. Draw Tools. This is useful when creating or editing your map. Game Log. Useful to keep track of conversations, game rules, and more. Game Tools. Useful for Fog of War, placing templates on the map, creating map markers, showing box text in the game log, and triggers. Library. This keeps all your maps, creatures, items, and handouts. Marketplace. Useful for when you want to download playable content or get more graphic assets. Options. Lots of options to run the game the way you like, and some customization features. Roster. In combat, this shows who's up and who's on deck. Out of combat, it shows all creatures on the map and allows easy find feature. SRD. This is useful for looking up rules while playing. And Help. This is useful for when you need some more information on how to do something with D20PRO.